Hi everybody, how's it going? Welcome back to Lamplight City, where things took a very, very dramatic turn in the last episode, didn't they? I'm still a little bit traumatised by it, to be honest. The general consensus from you guys in the comments is that that was going to happen regardless of the choice that we took. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go back and watch episode 2. Yeah, it really, really escalated very quickly. But we've had a bit of a time skip, and now we are here. So let's have a look around this bedroom.
Pretty, but I'm glad I don't have a sense of smell anymore. Wouldn't you say it's time for a change of clothes, Miles? You've been wearing that coat for who knows how long.
So? Addy gave it to me. Besides, it gives me character.
Right. Brooding detective in a long black coat. That's never been seen before.
What are you talking about, Bill?
Never mind.
Yeah, so Bill's narrating now.
I'm certain a permanent indentation in the shape of your rear is starting to form on that day.
Wouldn't surprise me from what it seems like has been going on.
Remember before you started taking that medicine and you could actually read a book for more than 10 minutes before falling asleep? You were a lot more fun to talk to back then.
So it seems like we're going through a very difficult period mentally here.
That's a fun little apparatus Adelaide got you. Very soothing.
Watching it spin long enough puts me right to sleep.
I'd say that's really more the soporifics doing.
Yep, probably true. Let's have a look at this painting.
I always liked that self-portrait of Adelaide's mother, even if the eyes do always follow you around the room.
Oh, it's one of those creepy paintings, oh no. What about this one?
Cozy little winter getaway. That would be a welcome change from the winters in this city.
There's the bed. It's a big bed, isn't it?
Don't worry, Miles. I don't watch when you and Adelaide are having your private time.
It would be nice if you didn't spend the whole time humming.
I thought you appreciated some romantic music.
No, thank you. Some pressed flowers up here.
Adelaide's mother certainly enjoyed pressing flowers. Do you suppose she does more of it now that she's retired?
Maybe, I don't know.
Miles, care to explain what you're doing?
Just checking to make sure everything that needs to be in here still is.
Right. If you start taking that stuff during the day, you're really going to have problems.
Yeah, we don't want to take any of those things during the daytime. So there's a dressing table, there's a poster. Can we open these up? It's very sort of dim in here, isn't it?
It's admirable just how organized Adelaide is. Maybe someday the same can be said about you.
Maybe.
That poster brings back some memories. That's from around the time you two met, isn't it?
Yes, back when Addy was singing at the Angel.
Ah, so she was a singer. Interesting. Right, let's head out then.
Well, look who's awake. Ready to rejoin the living?
Very much so.
You were talking in your sleep again.
Did I say anything interesting?
Do you ever?
You have to admit, she's got you there.
How are you feeling?
A touch groggy. I think I took a bit too much of the soporific last night.
That's what I thought. When you went for your after-lunch nap, you'd barely gotten breakfast down. I saved you some bread and cheese if you're hungry.
Thank you, but I haven't got much of an appetite.
You really should regulate your doses more carefully, love. I'm sure dull senses and an empty stomach aren't much help to your work. By the way, a message arrived via courier for you this morning. I put it on the table along with today's newspaper.
Thank you, dear.
Right, so we'll have a look at that in just a second. I want to take a look around the room because there's some pretty interesting looking things going on here. Lots of pictures, lots of decoration on the walls.
I always liked that painting. It's impossible to see that kind of scenery here in the city. It might do you some good to look in the mirror a bit more often, Miles.
It's pretty cool that Bill narrates all of this. I think that's a nice touch.
You remember how much time Adelaide had to spend convincing you to sit for this? At least these days, with ferrotype tech advancing the way it is, these portraits can be done in just a matter of minutes.
How times have changed. Obviously, this is like a parallel universe, but still, the point stands. What's this?
How are your parents doing these days? It's been ages since you wrote them. I can see why Adelaide calls that plant Miles Jr. It's a spitting image. Didn't I give you two that clock as a wedding present? Too bad it stopped working.
Yeah, too bad. Right, let's look at the bookcases.
Your book collection has always astonished me. Heaven help you if you ever decide to move.
Yeah, someone's gonna have to carry these all. There's a nice hanging plant here.
That makes me wonder what old Mrs. Hanbrook is up to these days.
Yeah, I was going to say, it reminds me of the first case that we were on. Whoa, the little, I guess it was an intro, really.
Adelaide's father certainly had an amazing life. Imagine being the personal barber to the Prime Minister and his family. The gossip and secrets he must have heard.
Huh, interesting job. Model ships, what's that about?
Building those model ships was a good way to pass the time between cases. Hopefully it'll be a while before you get enough time to build another one.
I like the music here, it's pretty cool. So there's a truncheon, a newspaper.
Ah, the Havisham case. Our first time out as partners. First in a long line of successful cases. It's nice to have a memory of the good old days.
Before everything went a bit wrong.
I'd love to see the look on Snelling's face if he ever found out you kept your old truncheon.
Oh, so we're not in the police anymore. Interesting.
Bolingworth Ale, my favorite. And a nice souvenir from the Angel. You really ought to go back there someday.
It's a desk here. It's a very small desk, it's got to be said.
It's been so long since you used that desk. Did you even notice when Adelaide got rid of the chair?
We could always pull one of these chairs over. I'm sure that's not a problem. Right, so we've got a message. Let's look at the newspaper first, and then we'll read the message. Ooh, okay. Remember the HMS Ligier? I don't even know how to say that. Anything about second bizarre murder baffles police in Chumley, similar to one which occurred just last month? I don't think it's related, just scanning through this. Have our finest detectives on the case and hope to find whoever perpetrated these awful crimes very soon. So it seems as though... I wondered if that was going to be something to do with Bill, but that was obviously before, I guess? I don't know. Maybe it is linked. Let's see the message. Fordham, a big case has come in which I think will interest you. Meet me at the is that the Rowan Coffee House for more details. See Upton.
Upton says she's got a big case for me.
Does she go into any more detail than that?
No. But then you know Upton, always on a need-to-know basis, especially since she's been giving me these cases under the table.
To be fair, they haven't exactly been anything of note.
True, but she's still sticking her neck out for me. I can understand why she's so secretive about it.
I think she just misses having you around the station.
Poor Connie. With you quitting and me dying, she must be bored stiff at work.
Anyway, I'm supposed to meet her at the Ruin Coffee House. That can't be right.
It's not like Constance to make mistakes. She must have gotten in somehow.
Guess I'll head over there and see what she's got then.
Oh, is it like an old abandoned place or something? Let's look in the casebook. Nothing else in here, so meet up to... It's the Ruin Coffee House, not Rowan. I misread it. Right, let's head out. Also, I am in love with this game already, and I'm glad to see so many of you guys down in the comments enjoying it as well. It makes me very, very happy to see that you're enjoying it as much as I am. So, let's head out, I guess.
Have a lovely day, Addy.
Give my regards to Constance.
Ooh, there's a map. Okay. So, Fenton Swamp. Chumley is over here. Leon... Okay, so, we're over here. Here's the coffee house. It looks like there's only one place we can go to at the moment. So, let's head over to the coffee house. Ooh, check this place out.
Ah, Rouen Coffee House. Worst Java in Lamplight City, but there's no better place to overhear all the rumors and gossip in town. Just make sure you don't get too close to the other patrons. Discretion was never your forte.
Probably true. Oh, whoa, look at that scythe.
What a cheery reminder of everyone's impending death. That whole thing about the man in the black robe, complete lie, by the way.
Well, I guess you would know. Right, let's... these dirty plates. Look at all the flies.
Not much of a hurry to clean up in here, are they?
Doesn't look like it. There's a couple of patrons around. I'm not sure... Oh, there's Constance. Some more patrons, sacks of coffee beans. Wow, this... The attention to detail in these environments is absolutely fantastic, I've got to say. It's really well done.
Nice seaside landscape. Definitely a stark contrast to the ambience in here. Dr. Tennyson's Vigor Pills. Absolutely guaranteed to restore vitality, youth, and vigor, or your money back. For use by men only.
Huh.
These things seem to have had a spike in popularity recently.
Wonder what they could be for.
Self-Portrait as a Desperate Man by B. Calvert. A bit like looking in the mirror, isn't it, Miles?
Alright, geez. So there's more advertisements over here. There's the coffee machine.
All that metal and tubing just to serve a hot cup of coffee?
Coffee machines have certainly changed. Some bottles, some barrels.
Seems like they have a little something for everyone in here. The specialty house brews. These are definitely not coffee.
Right, okay. There's a boiler.
A young woman holding a guitar. Completely the wrong way, I might add.
Yes, true, it's upright.
If this is how they store their coffee beans, it's probably a better idea to ask for tea. best avoid that one. He looks like he might tip over at any moment.
Yeah, he does. This one looks alright, though.
Reminds me of when I was alive. Good times.
Good times indeed. I actually really miss Bill. He was my favourite character up until the point where that happened, so...
He and his friend are having quite the conversation. I bet it's really boring.
We don't know that.
She's running back and forth at lightning speed. Clearly, she dips into the coffee supply. Judging by the sooty apron, this man is either a metal worker, a chimney sweep, or just really lazy when it comes to washing.
Who's this guy?
He's one of many patrons contributing to the oppressive thug in here.
Alright, what's the boiler for?
Give me an old-fashioned tea kettle any day.
Oh, it's for tea, okay. Right, let's talk to Constance then. Found out about this case, which is supposedly intriguing.
Here's my old friend, up to no good.
Up to no good.
It's good to see you.
How did you get them to let you in here?
It's rather simple, really. The owner and I have an understanding. He pretends women are allowed in coffee houses, and I don't report his unsavory business practices to Chief Snelling.
Sounds like a good deal. What sort of unsavory business practices are we talking about?
Oh, we haven't got time to get into that now. But take some advice. Don't order anything that isn't water.
Oh, God. Okay. I got your message. What's going on?
I got your message. What's going on?
It's time for you to join the big boys again, Fordham. Your days of finding lost cats are over.
So stop teasing me and tell me what it is already.
Do you know Madame Laura Dupre?
No. I can't say the name rings any bells.
Can't say the name rings any bells.
I'm not surprised. She's one of the Gascon Grand Dames. Doesn't really run in our kind of social circles.
Ah, right.
Madame Dupre died the day before yesterday. Her funeral was held this morning.
My condolences.
But halfway through the service, the mourners heard a loud knocking coming from inside her coffin.
Oh no.
She wasn't dead?
Apparently not. Nearly interred alive, although her doctor swears she had no pulse. Dupre's son Andrew was quick to suspect foul play. He accused a man named Albert Martin, and the police arrested him.
So where do I come in? Sounds like the case has already been solved.
I strongly suspect that Martin is innocent, especially considering the talk of him having used black magic on Dupre. The police feel they have enough evidence to convict, so they're not bothering to investigate any further. You're going to look into it and see if I'm right, then find the person who was really behind this.
Yeah, it does sound like their evidence is a bit sketchy. has Madame Dupre recovered?
Has Madame Dupre recovered from her ordeal?
I'm afraid not. Apparently she's been catatonic since they pulled her out of the coffin.
How unfortunate.
If you'd like to question Mr. Martin, he's being held at the Bow Street Jail. Or you could take a look around his house. It's at 451 Compton Street in Worcester.
And the Dupre home?
That's at Emmeline and Comtesse, right across from the old Angeline Convent. It's also possible you might run into the police during your investigation, since they're technically still on the case.
Thanks for the warning.
Well, it looks like we've got a number of locations.
Was there anything you wanted to talk about before you get started?
Well, let's try and figure out whatever we can.
Yes, actually, I had a couple of questions.
Let's hear them then.
Do we? Yeah, ask her about herself. Let's start there.
How are things going with you?
Work is hectic as usual, and I'm spending my day off in here. But considering my home life is still a shambles, maybe this is the best place to be.
I'm truly sorry about that.
Don't be ridiculous. If it hadn't been for you, I'd still be chained to that philandering bastard. It hasn't been easy, but I'm much better off this way. Trust me. Anyway, work gives me something to focus on. I'm sure you can relate to that.
Yes, and I'm grateful to you for getting me these case leads. I know you're taking a risk to do it.
It's the least I can do. How about you? How's Adelaide?
She's fine, although things between us could be improved, if I'm being honest. The less said about it right now, the better, I think.
I'm sorry to hear that. You can talk to me about it if you need to, although I'm probably not the best person to ask for relationship advice.
So it seems like maybe we're still investigating cases, but not actually part of the police. So I wonder if we're like a private investigator now or something.
Don't suppose there have been any developments regarding Bill's murder.
Unfortunately not. The department hasn't exactly been focusing on that case as a priority.
Of course.
The general attitude is that it was an accident. Bill died an honorable death in the line of duty.
Would have been nice if they bothered saying that at the funeral.
And of course there are still those who blame you for his death, Snelling being the first and foremost.
But the man who killed him is still out there.
Yes, I know, but it looks like you're on your own if you want to find him. My hands are tied. I can only ask around so much before the higher-ups get suspicious. Just don't give up. New Britannia may be a big city, but the criminal world is surprisingly close-knit. If you find any connections or leads during your other cases, be sure and let me know. I'll do the same if I find anything out.
So it's...
She has a priority straight. You could learn a lot from Upton.
I love how he butts into the conversation. Yeah, so it seems like we've got a bit of an ally in her, like a sort of link between ourselves and the police, which is quite cool. Let's review the case.
I wanted to go over the case with you.
Okay, what have you got?
What do you know about Madame Dupre?
Only what I've read about her in the paper. She's been married thrice, which I can empathize with, and she's extremely rich, which I can't.
What makes you think this Martin fellow is innocent?
The fact that the only evidence is the word of Dupre's son. I've seen this sort of thing thousands of times, and I'm sure you did too. They're just looking for a scapegoat. You're the only person I know who can put it right.
Upton's intentions are noble, but she has to realize this is just a drop in the ocean.
That's enough about the case for now.
Okay.
That's it, I think.
Then you'd better get back to it.
Yes, we had, and we've got several locations that
well,
we can visit.
I'm not entirely sure how this is going to help you find the flower shop burglar. But I suppose freeing an innocent man is a worthy diversion.
I agree. So, we've got the map up here now as well. So we've literally got the Dupre Manor, we've got the Bow Street Jail, and we've got 451 Compton Street. So I mean, we're going to have to visit all of them, aren't we? Let's be honest. We're going to have to visit them all over the course of the game, I guess. That's kind of weird that you can do that. But yeah, I'm really loving this so far. I'm completely hooked. I want to solve... You know, I've been told that there's more than one case and things, so it's going to be interesting to see how this all links together. I assume the person who's responsible for Bill's death is going to be involved in some way with everything that's going on. But we'll discover that all together, shall we? Which would be pretty awesome. I'm really glad you guys are enjoying it as well, and that makes me very happy. So, as always, thank you very much for watching. A big thank you to my patrons, Arcades Games, Wayne, Nate, Terminally Nerdy, Paul from the Phantom Fellows, and Lyle for all the support. I really do appreciate it. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button. Make sure you subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you all next time.